Hello, and welcome to Teach Engineering. My name is Ariana, and I am currently a junior at the University of Colorado Boulder, studying to become a biomedical engineer. Today, we're diving deep into a topic that often flows right under our noses, yet essential for our daily life: water. Have you ever wondered where the water flowing from your sink originates? Let's unravel this mystery together. So, where does your water come from? Mountains? Rivers? Reservoirs? What even is a reservoir? Reservoirs are key players in ensuring a constant water supply. A reservoir is a human-made lake formed by a construction of a dam. But why do we need dams in the first place? Dams are built for flood control, irrigation, hydropower generation, and of course, to ensure a reliable water supply for communities. But how do these dams lead to water flowing effortlessly into our homes? The answer lies in the interconnected web of water infrastructure. Water from reservoirs undergoes several treatment processes, ensuring that it meets the highest quality standards. From there, the water travels through an intricate network of pipes, making its way to your faucet. Imagine a world without dams. What do you think will happen? Well, we will have unpredictable floods, unreliable water sources, and a lack of sustainable energy. There are several different types of dams. For example, a dam using locks and canals, such as the series of locks of the Panama Canal, enables navigation to a human-made water route that must overcome elevation differences. In our exploration of water dams, it's only fair to shed light on the flip side, the disadvantages of dams. One significant drawback is the flooding of large areas of land, resulting in the destruction of precious flora and fauna. The consequences are profound, affecting ecosystems and displacing wildlife. With this in mind, engineers and scientists have embraced a revolutionary approach: adaptive management. This method involves carefully managing reservoirs and their release to mitigate harm to aquatic and terrestrial wildlife, plants, and the communities living downstream. So, next time that you enjoy a glass of water or take a refreshing shower, remember the journey it undertook, from mountain streams to human-made reservoirs, all made possible by the engineering marvel we call dams. Check out the lesson on Teach Engineering website and then use what you learn about dams and reservoirs in the associated activity, How Much Water Do You Use?